Welcome back. The time is now 7:40. Will Meyer, the movie guy, is with us, and this is like the cream of all crops. This is like your day.
This is my Super Bowl, yeah.
We're talking about the Oscars, but first, we do have one film we do want to talk about.
We do. Red Sparrow. This is a big movie that came out this weekend. It stars Jennifer Lawrence as a Russian ballerina who suffers a career-ending injury, and so she's then forced to enroll in Sparrow School, where she's taught the art of seduction to use her body as a weapon, and her first assignment involves a CIA agent, and it threatens to unravel both the security of the United States and Russia. And this is a movie I was excited about because it was co-written by an ex-CIA agent, so I thought it might have some authenticity, but I didn't really learn much of anything, and I think this is kind of a misfire for Jennifer Lawrence. It's a film that tries to be a lot of things. It wants to be a meaningful film about female empowerment, also a sleek, exciting thriller, and an intelligent one too. And I don't think it really succeeds at being any of those things, really. I think that it shows us by design a world that is very brutal and ugly. She's deprived of her individuality, of her freedom. You know, that's of course by design. But then asking us to enjoy this as just a fun, laid-back thriller, it's kind of too much to ask. I also think that the female empowerment message doesn't really work because it kind of feels like this movie is exploiting her character. And then it's just not all that smart either. One of the things I like, Leslie, about spy films is that they ask you to engage your brain. You have to think about what's going on. You have to keep up. That does not happen in this movie. It is a passive experience. It does have a cool twist towards the end, but you have to sit through 2 hours and 15 minutes of fairly flat material in order to get to there. I say fairly flat. This movie, despite it being, you know, unreasonably long, I wasn't bored. It held my attention, but it didn't do much else. I thought that Lawrence was great. I mean, she's an amazing actress, and she makes this movie much more interesting than otherwise would be. But overall, I have to think this is more of a miss than a hit for her. So I'm going to say 2 out of 4 stars.
2 out of 4. Yeah. Oh. Well, I'm a little disappointed because the promo looked
pretty
flashy.
I was really excited, yeah.
But hey, that's what they do, right? All right. Let's move on to the Oscars. Let's talk about the big one first, Best Picture.
Best Picture. This is the closest Best Picture race in years. So usually by this time you have a pretty good idea of what's going to win. Now it's kind of a toss-up. It's kind of a three-way race between Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri, The Shape of Water, and Get Out. Get Out won the Best Picture last night at the Independent Spirit Awards. So experts are giving Three Billboards the slight edge. It's won a lot of award shows thus far, but I got to go with my gut. I'm going to have a risky call here, and I think I'm going to say Shape of Water, just because I think that Three Billboards is just a little bit too risky for the Academy's voting body. I think that The Shape of Water is much more the movie they're likely to celebrate, something that is a visually stunning fairy tale romance about love and acceptance. I'm fully prepared to be wrong with this pick, but I'm going to go with The Shape of Water.
Got it. Hopefully there'll be no envelope mix-ups.
All right. Hopefully not.
Next one on the list. Let's talk about Best Actor.
Best Actor. I think that's going to be Gary Oldman for Darkest Hour. He's playing Winston Churchill here. It's a period drama. He had to transform himself physically. He's playing a real person. Leslie, those are all the things that Academy voters love when they're awarding performances here. So he's also won at most of the award shows thus far. If anybody's going to beat him, I'm going to say Timothy Chalamet. He won last night at the Independent Spirit Awards, but I'd say 80% chance that Gary Oldman wins this one.
And I think if you're right, you called this before. I think you even saw the movie. You said something like, "This is one that we're going to see an Oscar nom for it." All right, what about Best Supporting Actress?
Best Supporting Actress, Allison Janney, I think, for I, Tonya. It's a battle between two great character actresses playing two moms, Allison Janney for I, Tonya, and then Laurie Metcalf for Lady Bird. I think that Allison Janney is a great actress, and she has a big scenery chewing, showy performance here. Personally, I go a little bit more for Laurie Metcalf and Lady Bird, but Allison Janney has won at most of the award shows thus far, so I think she will win. But if you're going to see an upset in any category, this could be one of them. So I'm saying Allison Janney, but Laurie Metcalf could win.
All right, what about Best Supporting Actor?
Best Supporting Actor, I think this is going to be Sam Rockwell for Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. I love this guy. He's been giving great performances for 20 years. I'm so happy to see him being awarded this season. So, same reason for a lot of these other people. He's won at most of the award shows thus far, and so I think he's going to follow suit and win tonight.
Well, I'm interested to see if your predictions are correct. Where can people go for more info?
Facebook.com/WillMeyerTheMovieGuy. I'm filling out my ballot today. I will post it tonight so you guys can follow along.
So we'll get a sneak peek to see if you don't change halfway, right?